गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन. सो वी विल ट्राई टू फाइंड द मैथमेटिकल फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेकंड लॉ मोशन. मैथमेटिकली हाउ टू डिराइव, वील ट्राई टू डिराइव द फार्मूला टू फाइंड द सेकंड लॉ मोशन. ओके, सो वील डिस्कस विथ वन एग्जाम्पल. सपोज एन ऑब्जेक्ट ऑफ मास, एन ऑब्जेक्ट इज हैविंग मास m. And this is moving along a straight line. So an object has a mass moving along a straight line with an initial velocity u. Initial velocity is u. Okay, it is uniformly accelerated to velocity v in time t. Means what is uniform velocity? Generally we can call the final velocity. Okay. Uniformly it is moving with velocity how much? V in time t. By the application of a constant force F throughout the time. So for this to move an object in a straight line, we are applying force, we call unbalanced force. When you apply, initially it has u, zero velocity, then it is moving in a straight line with a particular time t, and you are applying a constant force f. The initial and final momentum of the object will be initial momentum we call first is p1 is equal to mu because it is initial. Then p2 is equal to mv because it has moved for a particular moment. Okay. As you know, the change in momentum is proportional to p2 minus p1. Change in momentum is proportional to p2 minus p1. Then this is p2 is given how much? Mv. P1 is mv. Mu. Okay. Sorry. P1 is mu. Now m is common here. M is common, v minus u. Okay. This is p2, change in momentum is p2 minus p1, final minus initial momentum. Okay, then rate of change of momentum. When you say rate, time is up because already the force you are applying throughout, constant force you are applying, and the time taken is t. So rate of change of momentum is proportional to m into v minus u by time taken t. Okay, so this is one. Then when you apply a force, or you can write, or the applied force, what is that applied force? F is proportional to m into v minus u by t. Okay, then so what we do here, proportional to, you see, if you want to remove the proportional, there should be one constant k. So k into m into v minus u by t. Then so f is already, you know, is equal to k into ma because we have one formula for force. V minus u is acceleration is equal to v minus u by t. This you can write in front of this also, no problem. You can can write here. We know that A is equal to V minus U by T. This is the reason. Because, okay. A is equal to V minus V by 2 is the acceleration, which is the rate of change of velocity. So this is nothing, it is rate of change of velocity. Okay. Now we will continue here. So we got F is equal to constant K into M A. Why we got the A there? Because A is equal to V minus U by T is nothing. It is rate of change of velocity is A is equal to V minus U by T, which shows acceleration. So, in this case, K is constant. This is K is called constant of proportionality. Constant of proportionality. And SI unit of mass, SI unit of mass and acceleration, are what actually they are kilogram, mass is measured in kilogram and acceleration is measured in meter per second. Acceleration we measure in meter per second square. Okay. So the unit of force is also so chosen that the value of the constant K becomes 1. So we will choose unit of force so that its the value of constant K becomes 1. So constant K value becomes 1. For this, one unit of force is defined as, so what we will define? One unit of force is the amount that produces that produces acceleration of one meter per second square in an object of 1 kg mass. So that is what happens here. One unit force is equal to K. Mass is already we know. 1 kilogram. And acceleration is 1 meter per second square. So this K value of K becomes how much? 1. So from the above equation, what happens? From the above equation, we get F is equal to M A. So the unit of force is kilogram meter per second square. So unit of force is kilogram meter per second square, or we call Newton. It is also denoted by N. So the second law of motion gives us a method to measure the force acting on an object. What does second law gives? Second law of motion gives us a method to measure the force acting on an object. Suppose this is an object. Okay, second law will allow us to give the method to measure the force acting on object as a product of its mass and acceleration. As a product of mass and acceleration. So second law will state that it will give the force applied on an object of mass m and with acceleration a. So second law of motion is often seen in action in everyday life. Everyday life we see the action. What is that? Have you ever noticed that while catching a fast moving cricket ball, while you are catching a fast moving cricket ball, what you will do? A fielder in the ground gradually pulls his hands backwards with moving ball. See, suppose a ball is hit by a batsman. Directly he will not hold here. He will hold here, but he will move his hand along with this ball backwards. Okay, means what happens there? In doing so, the fielder increases the time during which high velocity of the moving ball decreases to zero. Why means? See, as I told, when a fielder is in the ground, gradually pulls his hand backwards, means what happens there? The high velocity of the moving ball decreases to zero. When he takes his hand backwards, the high velocity with which the ball is coming towards him will reduce to zero. Thus, the acceleration of the ball is decreased, and therefore the impact of catching the fast moving ball is also reduced. First of all, acceleration decreases. Secondly, the impact, suppose the pain or the impact or the effect of that ball on the fielder will be reduced. Okay. If the ball is stopped suddenly, then its velocity decreases to zero in a very short interval of time. Suppose if you stop the ball quickly, its velocity decreases to zero. Thus, the rate of change of momentum of the ball will be large. The rate of change of momentum of the ball will be larger. If the ball is stopped suddenly, then its velocity decreases to zero in a very short interval of time. Thus, the rate of change of momentum of the ball will be larger. See, therefore, a large force would have to be applied for holding the catch that may hurt the palm of the fielder. So what you should do? You should apply little larger force when you are holding. When you hold with a larger force, and the force with which the ball is coming also will be reduced. That's why you are taking your hand back so that its force or its impact reduces to zero, and there may be no pain in catching that particular ball. Okay. So second example we will discuss here. In a high jump athletic event, what happens? The athletes are made to fall either on a cushion bed or a sand bed. You know very well. Whenever there is a high jump, athletes are made to fall on a cushion bed or sand bed. What is the reason? Same. This is to increase the time of athletes fall to stop after making the jump. So when they fall, their time should decrease, and after making slowly, they will not get it. This decreases the rate of change of momentum. First of all, it will decrease the rate of change of momentum, and hence the force. Your force also will decrease. So even karate player also. Try to ponder how a karate player breaks a slab of ice with a single blow. Karate player will try to break the slab of ice or even bricks also. Okay. Then what? See, now we will go for a simple explanation. Let's explain. See, the first law of motion can be mathematically stated from the mathematical expression for the second law of motion. Okay. So based on the first law of motion can be mathematically stated from the mathematical expression for the second law of motion. Equation 9.4. You can go through one textbook. Whatever I do read, you can get it. So we know that F is equal to ma. Okay. Or F equals to m into v minus u by t. Why? Because already we know a is equal to v minus u by t. Because a is equal to acceleration is rate of change of velocity. Or we can write Ft is equal to mv minus m u. That is, when f is equal to 0, v is equal to u. If when f is equal to 0, what happens here? V will be equal to u for whatever time. Whatever time is taken, if f is 0, v will become equal to 0. Sorry, u at the time taken. Time taken is t. This means that the object will continue moving with uniform velocity. Object is moving continuously with uniform velocity. Throughout the time t. If u is 0, you can add the value. If u is equal to 0, then what happens here? Then v will be equal to 0 also. If v is equal to 0, if u is 0, then v will always be 0. V will be always 0. Why? Because when initial velocity is 0, final velocity also 0. Oh, that is, the object will remain at rest. Means it shows that if v is equal to 0, means it shows that object is at rest. Object is at rest. So this is how the first law is proved by using the second law. Okay. So this derivation is there, but numericals are not there. Only you are studying here theory part with some examples, which will make you easier. Thank you. Have a nice day.